ever just wonder how the impossible happens?
Hi, I'm Seneca. This is Zelda the Wonder Dog.
Wonder, all right. That's Seneca Kruger, Zelda's foster mom for 7 months, shortly before Zelda departed for her new adoptive family in Chanhassen. She wasn't gone a few hours when Seneca started having regrets.
Out of 30, 40 foster dogs, what happens is you love them and then you let them go and you take in the next one. And with Zelda, I adopted her out and spent 3 days crying. I felt like I had lost my dog.
Meantime, 30 miles away in Chanhassen, someone else wasn't digging her new scene.
I think it was maybe 10 days. Yeah. And she was gone.
A whole lot of fresh dog tracks.
Seneca immediately joined the search.
3 times a week. I was out 4 or 5 hours.
We'll just keep searching.
And the days when it was 30 below were the days that I was most worried about her. I was out all day, outside, trying to find her so that she could be warm.
But Zelda was on the move. Dozens of social media sightings all the way to Orono, north of frozen Lake Minnetonka.
I never believed I wouldn't find her.
But Seneca needed help.
Our group is called START for Dogs. START stands for Search, Track, and Retrieval Team.
Nikki Taylor and Kathy Brunner joined the hunt, which suddenly went cold.
We thought she could be in the lake and didn't make it.
Then someone captured this photo 51 days after the last sighting along St. Mary's Cemetery in Minneapolis.
The START team got a hold of me and said, hey, look at this. And I said, oh, it's her. I think I put up 127 flyers in that neighborhood.
Why did you do that?
Because I love her. And I really believed that she was trying to find me, and I wanted to make sure that she didn't have to travel the rest of the way.
Little paw prints in the mud.
Seneca's search continued as Zelda crossed the Mississippi, seemingly on her way home, with the sightings now clumped in St. Paul.
When you saw she was 2 blocks from your house.
Oh, I couldn't sit still. I mean, I was just out. I would walk for an hour and then come back and see if she was here, and then immediately go back out and walk for another hour.
Then Zelda wandered into this alley behind the home.
She was very skittish.
Of Mike and Susan Willis.
I did start feeding right away just because that's what Susans do. They feed.
And sure enough, Susan's dinners kept bringing Zelda back, captured here just last week on a trail camera set up by Nikki and Kathy.
And I was thinking, oh, that is her. That's got to be her. She has a big fluffy tail.
Next night, the food was inside a trap when Zelda came back.
That was 4:34 in the morning, I believe, sleeping on the couch ready to go when I got that call.
Zelda had taken the bait. Seneca fell to her knees crying.
It's Zelda!
An implanted chip confirmed it.
You found me. I never stopped looking for you.
Nearly a week has passed. And Seneca is now officially Zelda's.
I think we believe that we choose dogs, but I really think it's dogs who choose us. And I think that that's what happened.
97 days, she brought us from Carver County to Hennepin County to Ramsey County. I wish I knew how she knew how to get here, but she made it.
And so we're left to wonder.
She's the wonder dog.
As life's best mysteries remain unsolved.
It's love. It's love. Yeah.
It felt good.
Boyd Hupert, Carol Evan News.
He's a good girl.
St. Paul.
Love that. The incredible journey, anyone? Well, Wigs and Whiskers, the animal rescue that placed Zelda, says the Chanhassen family agrees that Seneca should be her permanent owner. The adoption was finalized late this week. I don't know who owns whom in that relationship, Laura, but it is a beautiful relationship. It's adorable. And I have to say, the cat lover as well, we love you too, cats. We love you too.
Right.